equipo de Nerd Paranormal vuelve por cuarta vez a esta casa, donde fueron testigos en breves investigaciones de la actividad demoníaca, en la que incluso trataron de expulsarlo realizando un ritual, pero la situación se había vuelto peligrosa para ambos.
Все, друзья, подготовили мы ее к ритуалу.
Я так понимаю, человек говорит, что он селится, что ли? Смотри.
Да, и будет забирать душу моими руками.
Да будет так на земле.
Слышишь, да, сейчас?
Да.
Да будет так на земле.
Ась.
В общем, друзья, на этом все.
Ahora, decididos finalmente a concretar el ritual para atrapar a este demonio, el equipo se prepara, pero tan solo comenzando empezarían a ocurrir extrañas cosas.
Эту куклу нам помогла сделать наша помощница, которая помогает нам в ритуалах. В общем, после того, как мы проведем ритуал по заточению демона в эту куклу, мы поместим куклу в этот ящик. Здесь нарисуем символы, которые не позволят этому демону выйти наружу. После чего все как бы запечатаем и спрячем этот ящик, чтобы никто его не нашел, желательно. Как-то так.
Слышал? Пойдем проверим.
Кажется, это может и в комнате, фиг знает.
Ну, это как удары такие были. Что-то такое.
Похоже было на удары.
Мне кажется, что на шкаф.
Что вы думаете? Интересно, где он засел? Вот если сейчас откуда идут удары, значит, что сейчас он не там засевший где-то сидит.
Возможно, это.
Но надо его поймать как-то. Ну, сейчас ритуалом, в принципе, можно его поймать.
Нет никого вроде. Нигде. Не знаю.
Extraño sonido llama la atención de Tim y Dennis, quienes van a revisar el origen de este, pero no encontraron nada. Sin embargo, la actividad del lugar rápidamente se manifiesta ante ellos. Tal parece que el mismo demonio trata de disuadirlos para que se evite llevar a cabo este ritual. Aún así, el equipo de Nerd Paranormal continúa con lo planeado.
Символ, который присягивает.
в эту куклу.
Теперь свяжем ему руки.
Это пересос, мы уже переходим к ритуалу или нет?
Ну, сейчас свяжем руки, да, потом будем зачитывать конкретно душевое заклинание. Но это одна часть из ритуала, связывание рук. Также залил воском сейчас. Все, можно будет тогда приступать, зачитывать. Угу. Заклинание. Но с круга не выходи, только когда уже будем зачитывать.
Я понял.
Началось. Главное не выходи из круга.
Хорошо.
Он сейчас будет всячески нас пугать.
Эй!
Эй! Что? Что у тебя со светом?
Сейчас. Круга не вижу.
Я не помню, где этот фонарик делал.
Надо зачитывать. Помнишь, где на телескоп?
Сейчас, подожди.
Что с этим светом? О, я увижу, вижу где здесь, вижу.
И блядь.
Свет.
Денис.
Денис, я увидел.
Подожди, видишь, я ртал сейчас делаю. Сейчас не до этого.
Блядь, он со светом. Сука. Блядь, Денис, нахана, он как у него.
Не бойся, он в круг не войдет.
Где он?
Мури. Говорю то. Расында.
Свет. Сука. Нет,
свет. Не, это все равно, пока не выходи за круг. Давай, сейчас.
Где он, в кукле или нет?
Все, он должен быть в кукле, по идее. Получилось. Все. Теперь он у нас спрятался.
Luego de realizar el ritual, parece que han logrado aprisionar al demonio dentro de la muñeca, que ahora se encuentra atrapada dentro de la caja. Entonces, deciden esconderlo en el ático de la casa para que no vuelva a ser liberado. Pero...
Это Антек шевелится.
Не знаю, может быть шевелится.
Столько времени все время будет.
Да нет. Нет. Может. Заклинание я правильно читал.
Блин, короче.
Может он потом ускользнется?
Вообще не понимаю.
Первое время пока. Ну, так как он.
Ладно, короче, отключались, пошли.
Tim и Денис creen haber terminado por encerrar al demonio en la caja, pero poco después, Dargo recuerda que se olvidó poner unas marcas para asegurar el ritual. Así que regresarían para concretar totalmente esta sesión, pero algo no funcionó como esperaban.
Что там?
Пока не видно, сейчас.
Нет.
Чё?
Иди,
залезай. Ты залез?
Сейчас.
Смотри.
Ёбаный рот.
Охереть, блядь.
Как так-то?
Вырвался.
Цепь порвалась, что ли?
Нет, скорее цепь не порвалась, он мне замку просто. Замок вырвал, а цепь на место.
А pesar de lo ocurrido, Dennis piensa que pudieron encerrar al demonio dentro de la muñeca, tal como era su intención original, y desde allí ya no será posible volver a correr peligro en esta casa, o al menos esa es su idea. ¿Y tú crees que realmente puede haberse terminado la actividad demoníaca en este lugar? ¿O es posible que aún se encuentre esperando a su próxima víctima? Escribe tu opinión en los comentarios. El explorador paranormal Jan del canal Midwest Ghost Hunter en esta ocasión se adentra a explorar un antiguo pueblo histórico conocido como Bonanzaville, el cual se dice tiene varios edificios embrujados. Entonces, completamente solo y en la oscuridad de la noche, comenzaría a explorar, uno a uno, las diferentes propiedades del pueblo.
I heard there's a man that haunts this train. Who are you? Are you a conductor? Could you peer in this window in front of me? How about back here? Use whatever energy you can. Whoa. That was a tap on the glass. Did you just tap on that glass? Dude, I swear to God, it was on that window. That same window that I just requested for him to show. Was that you? Could you tap on that glass again? That was phenomenal. Could you do that again? It's like right here. Test it. See if it sounds the same. Yeah. That was literally this window right here. Could you prove to me that was you? Because this is an old train car, and I know it settles, so if you do it one last time, I'll know for sure it was you. All right, well, it didn't seem like much was going on in the train shed, but you never know. I have to review and maybe something might have showed up.
Luego del inexplicable sonido en el vagón del tren, Jan se dirige a lo que hoy se conoce como un museo de teléfonos, donde según testimonios se reportan haberse visto la entidad de una mujer en el lugar, además de que se hacen llamadas desde aquí a otra de las propiedades. Entonces, Jan entra a investigar para ver si logra captar alguna de estas afirmaciones. Y esto fue lo que pasó.
I heard there is a spirit here that makes phone calls to the other buildings. If you can hear me right now, could you make this phone ring? Could you call this phone? If you call it, I'll answer it. We could have a little chit chat. Well, these phones are dead, they're not even on. I'm not even sure if you'd even be able to make calls with it right now. Could you move this? The rotary dial? Whoa, what the? ringing in that room. Holy crap, that scared me. Did you just make one of the phones ring in that room? That was coming from that room over there. Oh god. Well, I suppose, let's go answer it.
I nearly jumped out of my skin when I heard this phone ringing. These phones were no longer in service, leaving this occurrence unexplainable.
And I'm like super jumpy it's gonna happen again, because I know if it happens again, I'm gonna freak out. Hello? Could you speak through this phone? Who called that phone earlier? Put my voice recorder up to it.
A faint whisper can be heard on the voice recorder. I cannot tell if it is actually coming from the phone, or if it's in the room with me. Either one is an eerie prospect.
Después del escalofriante incidente, ahora se dirige al hotel abandonado del pueblo, que se dice es el más embrujado del lugar, y donde se captó, en el segundo piso, esta fotografía. Entonces, siendo ya la medianoche, Jan entra a este hotel, y esto fue lo que ocurrió.
Is anybody in this saloon tonight? Enjoying a drink? Hey bartender, what would you recommend? If you're back here, could you move one of these bottles? Oh! Okay. I heard that. Is that you sitting at one of the tables? Could you make that sound again? Was you that made that sound? Could you do that again? If there's anyone in here, I invite you to come sit with me. I just want to get to know some of the people that are here. I hear that there's a lot of spirits in this building. Could you walk up to this table and sit down with me? I mean, I didn't bring any cards or anything, but I mean, if you've got some, I don't know if you can in the afterlife, but feel free to set it on this table here. Whoa. I just heard that chair move. Holy moly.
You can clearly hear the chair in front of me moving by itself. However, I unfortunately was shining my infrared light in the camera's view, inadvertently making the chair impossible to see. I did not capture the chair moving on my handheld camera either. However, I was about to document some of the most interesting communication I have ever received from a spirit.
Did you just sit down? Here, I'll put this next to you. If you just sat down, could you touch that green light? Whoa, what? Oh my god. Thank you. Wow. I'm gonna reach into your space here. I just wanna feel you. Oh wow. Dude, it is colder over here. Could you touch that green light again? Damn, dude. Holy shit. I am literally sitting next to a freaking ghost right now. Are you a male? If you are a male, could you touch that light? Yes. Whoa. Would you like to play a game of poker? Yes. Oh man, I would love to play a game of poker with you. I mean, I sadly didn't bring any cards or chips or anything. I kind of wish I did. Are you aware that this place is shut down? It's no longer a saloon. Are you aware of that? Or am I wrong? Is this place still open?
From your perspective, is this place still running? Yes. Wow. Wow, that is so interesting. That's interesting that for him it's open, but yet he can still interact with me. That is, my mind is kind of blown right now. Can you see me right now? Yes. Wow. Do I look solid? I'm gonna tell you this right now, and this might sound strange, but I can't see you. You are invisible to me. All I can see is you touching that light. Can you see me fully? Am I like a full person to you? Are you still there?
Jan logra registrar quizás una de las interacciones con el espíritu más increíbles, donde mediante respuestas a través de la luz del medidor K2, la entidad responde a preguntas concretas. Tal parece que para el espíritu aún ve el salón como si estuviera en funcionamiento. Adicionalmente a ello, también puede ver a Jan. Sin embargo, esto realmente es un museo oscuro y abandonado. Ahora, se dirige al segundo piso, donde se dice el ambiente es más pesado, y donde se captó la foto de un aterrador rostro, y tan solo un segundo después empezaría a captar algo inquietante.
Oh, 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 Jesus. I haven't even got up here, I already heard something. Hello? So far, guys, this floor is so much creepier than any area I've been in so far. I thought I may have heard somebody down here. Hello? Is there anybody in here? I might have heard somebody in here. Is there anyone in here?
Oh! Oh my God!
It's okay. It's okay. I'm not gonna run. Did you just tap on that bed?
Daylight's out of me. Holy moly. Dude, that was a freaking voice. I heard it so clear on this voice recorder. It was a female. It's a female voice. It said, like, who are you? I heard it. It sounded like, who are you?
This woman's voice was so vivid, I was almost convinced it was a real person. Yet, as you can see, I am the only one in this old hotel.
I'm sorry, ma'am. I didn't mean to freak out earlier. It just kind of caught me off guard when I heard you. I definitely heard your voice. Could you speak again? And by the way, my name is Ian. Where are you in this room? On this bed? If you're on this bed, could you move the blankets? I overheard that brothel work used to take place here. Are you, no disrespect, but lady of the night?
Are you touching this bed? I keep hearing you.
Wow. That was a heck of a string of activity. Jeez, that woman's voice was so clear on here. I still can't believe that.
There's no doubt in my mind I was not alone in that room. And I'm not sure who that was.
Man, I just felt like a cold breeze just passed me.
Did somebody just go in front of me here?
That's just like a wicked chill I got there. Just seconds after I walk out of the room, a mist-like form appears from thin air. I can't help but imagine this being the spirit of the woman getting up off the bed and passing by me in the form of a cold breeze.
Hasta el momento, Jan estaba captando escalofriantes pero increíbles evidencias de actividad paranormal e interacción con espíritus. Y ahora, continuando su investigación a través del pueblo, ahora se dirige a lo que solía ser una mansión, conocida como la Mansión Houston, en la que, luego de fallecer sus dueños, David, quien solía ser inventor, agricultor y poeta, y Annie, una talentosa música, los empleados del lugar creen que la entidad del dueño aún se mantiene en la propiedad, tratando de ahuyentar a todo aquel que se acerque.
Annie, ¿do you want me to leave?
Whoa! Dude, I just freaking heard a whisper.
This clear and articulate voice of a woman comes right out of nowhere. I believe that I was communicating with the spirit of Annie, and this was her voice inviting me to leave.
Alright, so there is a particular closet that I was told about, and it is supposedly the creepiest area for a lot of people. A lot of people don't like going in there, and they think that David maybe developed photos in there. So I'm gonna go into that closet, and I'm gonna shut the door, see what happens. Okay. I could definitely see the creep factor. David? You don't mind me entering here. Is this your closet? Well, so far so good. David? Is this where you developed your photos?
Oh! I came from the stairs. Okay. Holy crap, that was loud.
Hello? Is there somebody up here? Okay, I thought I heard something up here.
Oh God, that was a scary voice.
This deep and gruff man's voice sent shivers down my spine. I immediately felt a strong presence, and the atmosphere became heavy. After analyzing the audio, the voice sounds like it is saying,
A pesar de haber escuchado esta escalofriante voz, Jan decide subir a investigar el lugar, pero algo más captaría su atención.
I heard you died of a brain hemorrhage, and I'm very, very sorry to hear that. Are you the one that leaves the imprint on the pillow? Could you do it right now? Thank you. What is that? Mom? Somebody downstairs? What the heck is that? It's like a jingling sound. What the heck is that? It's down there. How is that even possible? Look at that. You're freaking moving like crazy. That's her seance table. That's even more terrifying. Oh God. How is that even happening? There's no air in here or anything. Oh God. Look at that. They're still moving. Oh, what? Dude, this camera just died.
There is absolutely no explanation for the crystals on this lamp to be swaying back and forth so rapidly. To top it off, when I approached the table, both of my cameras suddenly died despite being at full battery just moments ago. After this happened, I began feeling lightheaded and decided not to go back into the mansion.
Jan ha experimentado y registrado muy interesante e inexplicable actividad paranormal en cada una de las propiedades. ¿Cuál de ellas te pareció más espeluznante? ¿Serías capaz de pasar una noche en este lugar? Si deseas ver el video completo y más exploraciones de Jan, visita su canal y suscríbete. No olvides decir que vas de parte de Realidad Alterna. Muchas gracias. Un agradecimiento especial a los miembros y patrocinadores de este canal. Si tienes videos que quieras compartir o deseas que salgan en las próximas recopilaciones paranormales, escríbeme al correo que aparece en pantalla. No olvides seguirme en Paranormal Clips, donde hay diverso y exclusivo contenido paranormal. Muchas gracias. Si deseas tener acceso anticipado a los estrenos y más ventajas, puedes hacerte miembro del canal. Te dejo estos 4 videos que sé te van a aterrar. Esto es Realidad Alterna.